All right, hello guys. In this episode, we will actually be building a tag from scratch, because some people I know recommended I should do this from the beginning, so I'll go ahead and do my process. We'll do a quick one. It'll be a few videos long, but it will be enjoyable. All right, well, first, I would go to my saved stock images that I always get from, you know, the site called Fringe FX, and Fringe FX really, because, you know, that's really where I get all my stocks from. Okay, well, you know, I'm not in the mood to do anything fancy, you know. I mean, I could crop the guy out in here and just do, you know, your basic, I just shot you in the face and made a tag and it looked cool kind of one. So ow. Let's see. Let's open the never before seen stock pack. Me no like. Well, since I do have renders, we'll go up and open a render pack. Hopefully we'll find one we like, you know. I typically don't find one when I'm in certain moods, but, you know, it happens. Alright, bunch of anime. The person that put this together is really into TV and video games. Don't get me wrong, these are wonderfully cut renders, it's just they're not my thing. Oh. Hold on. I might actually like this one. You know, I'm actually going to try to work with this. No, I'm not. Yes, I'm picky. Don't patronize me. That's not nice. Alright. No, I already went there. Okay, well, we're gonna go to my resource packs that, you know, I get just about everything from Fringe. No joke. Bokeh. I don't know why it says bokeh. I don't even know what that means. Probably something in a different language that probably makes me sound gay right now or something. I don't know. Alright, stocks. Let's see one I like. Nope. You know, guys, I'm actually going to try to work at that render. Believe it or not. I typically don't use renders because, you know, they're not my thing. So I control A and cut the whole entire thing. I'm gonna use a typical canvas that I use. It's a 500 by 200 or 300. No. I'm gonna change proportions to 400. We're gonna do a thin one. Let's get a thin one. Paste in our rendered image. I'm gonna throw it in there and be like, whoa, okay. Oops, don't wanna do that. Alright. That's something I really do. I really don't like it when I cut off a head, so we're gonna start over. And do a 500 by 300 height. There we go. Pretty sizable canvas, huh? Allows room for creativity. Put him in here, be like, oh! Alright. Something I usually always do is I invert the background so it's black and makes it easier to work with. The reason I turn the eye off on the render so I could build a background made out of stocks and using blend option to create interesting looks. Well, I really like this one, so I'm gonna go ahead and open it. this nice vibrant color to it. Of course, it won't be sustained once I get the thing, and then yeah, I'm gonna go with this one because of the blue, the colors, and the smooth textures it has in it. The smoke, anyways, and then let's see. Prosperity. I'm trying to make sure not open certain ones because you guys would like be blinded by them. And I've seen this one use like a crap load, so I'm gonna cut that one. I'm going to go to our original document and paste it in. Since I feel like the size is a little big, I'm going to go ahead and shrinkify it a little bit and put it right there. I'm going to leave it on normal for now. Oops. I'm going to go over to this one, shrink her down from 3,000, holy crap, to like 1,000. Cut. Don't save it because you just screw up your old picture. Oh, we capture all those rich lighting textures going on. And that smoke. I like. I'm going to go to this other one. The vibrant. She's like, blam! Look at the lights. Fabulous. Alright, and I'm going to put it in there. Alright. Getting a good spot. Alright, now we're going to mess with the blending method. Thing. We're gonna have this one. We're open this one, and we're just gonna go down this list from darkened to the bottom. No, not linear burn, not darker color, definitely not lighten or screen, or color dodge, linear dodge, lighter color, overlay, soft light, hard light. Maybe hard light. I'll think about hard light. I actually kind of like that. But I'm probably going to have to go with hard light on this one for once. It's rare that I use hard light. Alright, the next one, I'm probably going to go ahead and just throw it on difference, just see what it looks like. Ooh, I kind of like that. But because the colors don't match our little buddy here, little gas mask, hazmat suit man. Get some color filters going on. First, we're going to go ahead and do a save as, just in case my computer crashes while I'm doing this. It doesn't get messed up. Oops, went too far back. PSD, where is it? There we go. Save it as Untitled 2. I hope it's not one I'm working on right now. Alright. Layer, let's see, a photo filter. Alright, I've got some time. I'm gonna do about five more minutes on this one. Alright, warming filter. Heck yeah, I'm gonna move it up to 50% density. There, we're gonna do another photo filter. I'm trying to brown this stuff out, guys. I'm supposed to get a sepia tone going on. Ironically, we're gonna throw in a sepia filter at 25%. Get another photo filter. A little cyan, not cayenne. Definitely not cayenne, that's that pepper. What about a deep red? I actually kind of like that. Let's see what the focal looks like with it. Oh, that kind of works. Kind of. Let's keep throwing in photo filters. I'll balance it out. Yeah, photo filter. Open. Warming filter 81. We're just going to crank that up. 50. Alright, and then do gradient map, black and white, and close that, and then do it on soft light, help bring out all them colors, and darken it up, you know, add contrast, I think it is, contrast, so you get all that, it's blam. Alright, now we have our background built. Now we're going to go ahead and Control S and save. Oh, don't ding at me, computer. That is rude. You don't do that to me. You rude, man. Anyways, we're gonna have to. This is a little difficult for once. Let's get some Illustrator shapes pulled out that I already have. Let's see, resource shapes. I think it's a, yeah, C4Ds and Illies. I'll give you a link to this guy's, oh, crap. Can we get better previews? Medium icon, extra large, oh, flipping pants. This kind of sucks. Oh, let's make a stab at it. We'll go for number 6. Ooh, yeah. I'll give you a link to these, Illustrator shapes. Dang it. To reopen that. Yeah, I'll give you a link to these Illustrator shapes. His name is Stinky666. He's very smart. You give the guy credit. Alright. Copy. Go ahead and copy that. Paste it in. Stinky is a genius. As bizarre as his name sounds. Alright. This is a little awkward shape to work with, but I like using this stuff. He's a pretty cool guy. Never really talked to him, but he seems like a really awesome guy. Ooh, let's draw this on. We might have to scrap the Illustrator shapes, because this is a 3D object. Control C. We paste this beef. I'm just gonna cover it up. We'll cover up. Cover up. Alright, 147% with the pixelies. Alright, move it over. Move down some, but like, ooh. Alright, see, I like that, but. Joey behind there, it'll help us out a little bit with covering, so we'll leave him, but color, the red is just so out there. So new hue saturation layer and try to get it as orange as we can. That is a nice orange. So clipping mask, so it only affects that one. Ooh, but it can be a purple kinda. Alright, well, good thing we made a clipping mess, so we can just use that. Ooh, vibrance. Ugh. We have to go with a darkish purple. Dark blue purple thing. There we go. Purple. I'm going to duplicate that hue saturation layer, move it down to the other Illustrator shape and clipping mask it, and then bam, we got some crazy purple going on. Well, I'm going to save now. Because that is the end of that of part one of this bizarre creation that I just thought up of out of the blue. But like, comment, favorite, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. And all likes, comments, and you know, subscriptions are appreciated because it helps support me as an artist and a fellow YouTuber.